Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. It's just wonderful to see so many people here well beyond their expectations. Now, before we begin, if you have a mobile phone, you might like to disarm that one, put it on the quiet list. We have a special welcome to the residents from St. Joseph's Nursing Home at Kensington, and also for the Little Sisters of the Poor down here at Market Street. You're very, very welcome, and I think you're very, very brave to come out on a day like today. A special thanks to those who accompanied you here today. Now, there's supposed to be a bit of action going on behind me while I was speaking. So our first item is the introduction to the Gloria by Antonio Vivaldi. I think you've all have notes there, so I won't dwell on that. The second is Let the Bride Seraphim Sing. That's by Friedrich Handel, George Friedrich Handel. And the words, if you don't happen to have a program, are very beautiful. Let the Bride Seraphim in burning robe, their loud, uplifted angel trumpets blow. Let the cherubic hosts in tuneful choirs touch their immortal hearts with golden wands.
Thank you. number is a piece by Bach, which he originally wrote for the harpsichord. It's called the Italian Concerto. And in this work, he tried to imitate an instrumental concerto, whereby we have a solo instrument accompanied by an orchestra. In this case, the solo instrument is my right hand. So try and have a listen for the contrasting effects between the orchestral sections and the solo section. Afterwards, the choir and Cinzia will sing a beautiful little gem by Mozart called Laudate Domino. If you're regular to this parish, you know we usually sing this during the Easter Vigil celebration.
Thank you. Australian National Shrine to Our Lady of the Sacred Heart. And in honour of this, we've included three musical tributes, especially to Our Lady, in today's programme. The next piece is the first of these, from Verdi's opera, La Forza del Destino. This is Leonora's heartfelt prayer, seeking the Blessed Virgin Mother's help, her guidance, but above all, her protection. Do feel free to close your eyes, it's a beautiful piece, and offer up your own prayers of intercession to Our Lady while we sing to you beautiful and reverent, La Vergine degli Angeli.
Thank you.
our Blessed Mother, is Ave Maria, which many of you I'm sure would have heard before. Gounod was inspired to write this moving melody to the accompaniment of Bach's harpsichord prelude, which was composed some 200 years earlier. So between the two of them, Gounod and Bach, thank you, because the result is heavenly.
Thank you. Thank you.
keynote, third movement. What's of interest here is that Ravel did record a piano role in the first two movements, but he felt quite unable to play the technical third movement, which he composed himself. And he frequently left an hour while playing concerts in America in the late 1920s. So how special are we if we have Tony Abbott-Palmer to play the technical third movement for us?
Its message is a simple one, but a powerful one, about love, the importance of loving and being loved above all else. Riches, wealth, power, status, none of these matter without love, because love is the greatest gift of all. Many a composer has waxed lyrical over centuries over this very topic. But as my dear father always used to say, no one does it better than Signor Puccini.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
speakers just for a moment. We have a few little gifts here to give to our special soloists and accompanists. To Jessie, firstly, who comes from across the bridge. She's the only one who's not from these parts of the world, or at least not totally. Very often here in our church, especially here for the High Easter ceremonies and Midnight Mass, but on a special occasion for us here is our Anzac Day Mass, where Tom comes faithfully every year and plays the Reveille at the Last Post. Thank you. Our flautist, Alana Thorne, is in year 9 at St. Vincent's. She's from St. Margaret Mary's Parish, which is part of our parish set up here too. Thank you also most faithfully for your coming to our practices, and what a wonderful talent you have. Thank you. The quiet man of the outfit is Randy Abitabo, brother to Tony. But a wonderful talent, a great man to work with, and his conducting and leadership of the choir. But I think most conductors would want to throw the baton on a few of us, especially the bassos. He's got a great sense of humour, a great patience. Thank you, Randy. His brother is Tony. Well, now we've seen the talent of Tony here again, enormously generous. But I can't begin to imagine the amount of work that has gone on preparing these pieces and this whole program. Now, this beautiful grand piano is going to be a great loss to you, Tony. I know it goes back to its dwelling place, which is in some storage shed somewhere or other. So we're hoping one day that we will have our own grand piano here. Hint, hint. And I think it's very worthy of the band that we should have such an instrument as this in our parish. So hint, hint. So Tony, thanks seems very threadbare when we think of all that you do for us and all that you are for us in our parish here, and how our music has taken wings since you've been here, and especially with our combined choir. So thank you. Cinzia Montresor, my treasure as a bird in Italian, and she was singing about treasures there, and she sang so beautifully too. Such a magnificent voice. I can't quite put the voice and the body together, but it's just so wonderful. It fills the entire place here. And since Cinzia has joined our combined choirs, Cinzia is from St. Margaret Mary's Parish, as also is Alana, got to mention that. And it's just brought an added dimension to our liturgy, to our worship, to our sense of faith and joy and prayerfulness. And isn't it true that beauty, I think anyhow, is a royal road into the mystery of God, into transcendence? And Cinzia certainly brings great beauty to our liturgies, to our gatherings, and has a wonderful personality as well. Thank you.
Thanks for making all this happen.
You know, they're quite party animals, many of them too. You wouldn't think to see living with them here so serene and calm and beautiful. So thank you, they are a really delightful group, and many hours of work that you put into it, and I know we get much more back than we give. Now finally, we only had a taste, a sensation of the lonely at the beginning and at the very end. And I'm afraid we didn't cater for so many people, so you might get a taste of food and maybe a taste of wine or soft drink if you wish to go that way through the foyer. But otherwise, thank you so much for your presence, and this has been a great fillip for us too. Go safely.